I believe that everyone who's standing here tonight is standing here for a reason. I think that everybody knows that they've come here for a purpose and knows that they've come here for something that they believe in. And not just believe in a logical way, but something that has moved from their head to their heart. I believe that there are people here who are carrying a candle, maybe for someone who's deployed, maybe for someone who's standing in the gap, maybe for someone who has passed. But I know that these are lights that are lit. These are lights that people can see. And each light represents truth. And we may think sometimes that when we're talking, that because we live in a world of darkness, there's people that don't hear, people that don't see. But I believe that everything that we did today, people saw. There are soldiers right now at Walter Reed Army Medical Center who told me they could hear that. They could hear that cheering and that encouragement from the sixth floor of their hospital ward. There's soldiers who have gone home from Walter Reed who have told me that they felt alone inside their rooms. They felt depressed and that they didn't know how to get out of that dorm room, but they heard encouragement, they heard cheering, they heard cars honking their horns. Something caused them to come out there. And they may have thought, oh, it was just to take a picture or grab a soda, but what they saw was what you did tonight. And they didn't just hear their voice, and we know there's some people who have some very loud voices, but they also saw that light that you're holding in your right hand. And I know that there's people here who have been veterans themselves, and those are people who relate to the soldiers, who help soldiers to understand and can speak in ways that sometimes civilians just might not be able to. I've seen Vietnam veterans come into Walter Reed and come into the outpatient lobby and sit and talk with our soldiers. And the fact that it might have been talking about a game of cards or maybe talking about just something real common, like their hometown, but that's a detail that was arranged to talk and help that person. There are people at our colleges that really don't like to sit in long and boring lectures and really would like to just get to the point, because they're military, and because they served, and because every day, not only was their life on the line, but they put their ideas and their beliefs into practice. And we know sometimes that we might feel that calling to go and do that right out of high school, and sometimes we might say, hey, I want to sit here in college. Or sometimes we fight what it is that we're supposed to do, and that's okay. That can be a really good thing. But I just know that when I met Free Republic, when I met Free Republic on a really cold January night, that I wasn't just going to have hot chocolate or to just kind of rah-rah outside of Walter Reed. I saw people who cared about what they believed in and were willing to put that into practice 110%. I saw families who pulled their kids out of school to stand outside in the cold. I saw people who made sacrifices, who stood so strong and sang the Blue Star songs and stood in the gap for their child. And so for whatever it is that you're here, tonight is not the end. Tonight is just the beginning, because when you're walking tomorrow, you're carrying that same light that's in your hand. You're not a tourist. You're not a whatever it is your job title is. You're not even a kid in the candy store anymore, because now you're walking in that light. And I know there's going to come a time where, sad enough, we're asked to snuff out this candle. But really, it's the freedom that lives on, the freedom that comes from being in this country that can never, ever, ever be extinguished. And sometimes we want so much in this life to light things up. Everybody here came out on a sacrifice, came out on a limb, maybe even on some short notice. So when you blow out that candle, when that time comes, it's not extinguished, but it's only beginning, because you're standing in the gap for many Americans tomorrow. When you're ready, and when you're ready, not the person next to you, you can go ahead and blow out the candle.